season. One of my favorite players growing up. He was actually my favorite player growing up. I remember after all of, you know, after their games the next day, I would get my laptop out in between classes and I would watch all the highlights. I would watch literally every single shot that he took from every single. So much more to give, but let me go ahead. I'm gonna give Kobe all of the minutes here. You know what? Oh, you know what we need to do? Train logic. I'm turning that off. I know I'm like totally cheating here, but I want to reunite Shaq the story of that league just can't be told without them. And Kobe Bryant is obviously one of those guys. Michael Jordan, one of those guys. Shaq, Kareem, you know, Dirk, players like that. And so Kobe was a five-time NBA champion. He won an NBA MVP. He was a two-time scoring champion, an 18-time All-Star, 15-time All-NBA team selection. And this is the crazy part, he was a 12-time All-Defensive team selection. So not only was he getting it done on offense, but he was the type of player who would come at you on defense. Not be at work. That was just the kind of player that he was. On top of all that, he was a two-time Olympic gold medalist and voted the player of the decade for the 2000s. And outside of basketball, he had also just won an Academy Award in 2018. I believe he actually produced an animated short film, and he was working on like cartoons and stuff. I know he was big in body armor, and I don't know, man, it just, it felt like he was really, really just getting to start to enjoy and appreciate everything, you know. And he put so much into the game. He gave us so much. It's just crazy how quickly, you know, things can change. I remember when I first heard the news, it was one of the very few moments in my life where I could say it was just surreal. And, you know, not that I would ever wish that on anybody else. I was hoping it was some kind of mistake. Like, maybe he wasn't on that helicopter. Maybe it was, this sounds terrible, but maybe it was somebody else, you know. But it was crushing to hear that it was him, man. He's just, I just saw the news, I was like, no. And his daughter sitting courtside, and he was, you know, pointing out the things he was seeing and just teaching her the game. And I know he never ended up having a son, but I really feel like she was going to carry on his legacy. I feel like she would have been a monster in the WNBA. So, Zion wins rookie of the year with 0 points, 0.5 rebounds, and 0.5 assists per game. Sixth man defensive player of the year. Most improved as well. And Frank Vogel, the Lakers coach, gets coach of the year. Okay. Team Kobe Bryant, of course, and all defensive second team. Shaq's on there too, as well as Michael Ray Richardson. Okay, guys, and now is the moment of truth we have to win in the playoffs. Okay, 1-0. It's on the Celtics. I'm not sure. I don't know. Let's go ahead. I want to do the simcast on these. And also, isn't it just... It just like blows my mind how this... passed him on the all-time scoring list. You know, even his last tweet was congratulating him and encouraging him to keep going. And it's just, that's just the type of guy that he was. You know, he set all these records, but he also appreciated greatness. And yeah, it just takes an incredible type of person, incredible human, to have that kind of humility to support someone breaking your records like that. Let me speed this up a little bit. Really back and forth game. So we're down 2-1 here. Simulate with Simcast again. But yeah, it just hurts my heart, guys, for his wife and his daughters. Imagine how that Stop.